Hi, I'm Mike from the PlumbingSupply.com. Today we're going to talk to you about compression fittings, how to size them correctly, and how to attach them and not make them leak. So we'll get started here. The first thing we want to do is we want to find out what kind of pipe or what size of pipe you have. In this case, compression fittings are used on copper. They can also be used on a polyethylene or even a clear vinyl with the right fittings, and we're going to talk about that in a minute. Right now we're going to size the pipe, and we're going to take it and you're going to size it by the outside to the outside. And in this case it measures 5/8 from the outside to the outside. So we're going to use 5/8 compression fittings. When you're choosing a compression fitting, you want to make sure that the size of the fitting matches the size of the copper tubing. We're reiterating this because it's very important. Because compression fittings are sized by the outside diameter of the pipe, where copper sweat fittings are done by on the inside of the copper tubing. We're going to use the outside diameter of the copper pipe to size your fittings properly. Now, one of the most important things about a compression fitting is how it seals, and so it's important that you put the sleeve on without damaging it. But the first thing you want to do is put a nut onto your pipe, slide it down, and you want to put your sleeve on, and you're going to slide it down, be sure not to mess up the sides of the sleeve. Now, when you put the fitting on, you put it on as far as you can go, because then you slide the sleeve back with the nut to make it seal. The sleeve is what seals it against the nut on the inside. And on the inside of the fitting. So as it compresses, it makes a seal. It's important when you're tightening the fitting that you hand tighten. Make sure that you get it threaded on correctly. So you want to hand tighten it first to make sure that it is threading on properly. When you're tightening compression fittings, you want to use a smooth jawed wrench. In this case, we're using a crescent wrench. And so you just put it on and you tighten it down till it's very snug. You don't want to over-tighten it, but you want to get it snug enough to where it's not going to leak. So a lot of times the trick is to tighten it with the wrench, and then when it's fairly, really snug, then you can put your water pressure on, and if it's still slightly dripping, then turn it a quarter of a turn at a time to tighten it down until it stops leaking. Then you'll know for sure it's not going to leak. You can reuse a compression nut and a compression sleeve when it's already on a pipe. So if you want to extend the pipe, you want to maybe have some repairs to make, and you still want to be able to use this fitting again, you can take it off. Again, we're going to use a couple of wrenches to tighten it. And you'll notice that the compression sleeve has compressed itself onto the copper tubing. So the sleeve will move, the nut will move, but the sleeve will not. When you want to reuse the fitting, when you put the fitting back onto it, the trick is not to over-tighten it, and that's the most common mistake. So you want to make sure that you just, again, hand-tighten the compression fitting on, or your nut onto the compression fitting. Just hand-tighten it. And then you just want to take a quarter of a turn more with a wrench and just snug it down. You don't have to reseat it like you did the first time, so you don't have to really wrench on it. It's already been seated, so now all you're doing is tightening it and to make a seal. Another thing we wanted to mention is that you want to make sure that you do not use any kind of Teflon tape on the threads or any pipe dope, because you want the seal to take place against the sleeve. And if you put pipe dope or Teflon tape on the threads, then the nut will not tighten down all the way as it needs to be. We also talked earlier about using polyethylene tubing or plastic tubing to attach to a compression fitting. Now, it's important that when you're doing that you don't let the polyethylene tubing or plastic tubing collapse when you're tightening into the compression fitting. So they do make insert fittings that fit right inside of the tubing, and that will keep it as it's being compressed against the compression nut against the fitting. It won't crush the pipe to where it won't be usable. When you're going to attach the polyethylene tubing to a compression fitting, you want to make sure the insert's inside there, but you may sometimes the plastic sleeve that goes over the top of it may not fit. So again, you want to put the nut on first and then slide your sleeve over. In this case, we're using a plastic sleeve so it doesn't bite and cut into the polyethylene tubing. And then we put your insert in to keep it from collapsing. So now when you're tightening it onto your compression fitting, it's just like it doing it to copper, and the brass insert keeps the plastic from collapsing as you tighten it on. Now if you want to go as a compression fitting, they make all different kinds of compression fitting and adapters to go to a different kind of piping. So if you do want to go to like an iron pipe size thread, they make fittings that will still attach onto compression fitting. And then they will attach, again, if you're going to use iron pipe thread, you have to use Teflon tape on this part, never on the compression, but you do want to use it on a pipe thread, so you put Teflon tape on it, and then it will screw onto this, to a compression fitting. We hope we've helped you understand how to use compression fittings. My name is Mike, I'm at the PlumbingSupply.com, and we thank you for watching.